workers in Delano, California, have begun an unprecedented strike in the Central Valley.
We believe the United Farm Workers and their leader, Cesar Chavez, represent the hope and aspirations of the vast majority of farm workers.
Every American has a stake to bring about social change within the system.
So who the hell is this Cesar Chavez?
Yeah, I heard he's Mexican.
Seems a safe bet.
I'm angry that I live in a world where a man who picks your food can't feed his family.
We don't need you. We want you back to Mexico. Get the hell out of our country.
What do you think you're looking at, huh?
The citizens of Delano, they respect the law.
So do we, especially the Bill of Rights.
Have you seen the headlines they're getting? That's costing us real money, Mr. Bogdanovich.
We don't have to negotiate. We have to dictate terms.
Last report estimates that we've cost them $17 million.
Michael, your career, I mean, you've been doing a lot of diverse roles, and I've liked from End of Watch to American Hustle to this, but this movie just seems so much more important because I learned something.
Right.
There you go.
You're right, my bad. I liked it right off the gate.
Because I learned something, man, I feel like I probably represent most Americans where we probably heard the name but really don't know the story.
Yeah.
How important do you think it is to, like, learn these historical figures, and do you think it, like, it makes it easier to identify with different cultures when you learn these stories?
Well, yeah, I mean, I think that right now, man, life is changing. You know what I mean? We have Barack Obama as the president. I mean, at one point, like, the best golfer was black. The best rapper was white. Things are definitely changing, man.
Yeah.
And it's good to know, and, like, I don't know, I think it makes America unique, to be honest with you. I'm like, I think that, times are changing, and it's weird because we're going to look back, and we're like, wow, it really changed, and it started all around, you know, these last 25 years. And I'm like, it's pretty special, you know what I mean? I'm like, you just got to take everything in. But this guy, you know, did something really cool in the 60s and 70s, and there's some people trying to do that now, and I think it's a great acknowledgement. But also, you want to entertain people when you're telling this guy's story, you know?
Yeah, and I don't know where it went from there. I know there's still a lot of migrant farmers and everything else, so I'm not sure if all of their rights have been realized. Do you think if Cesar Chavez was here today, that he would be satisfied with the progress thus far, and you think he would still be fighting for more?
I think he'd still be fighting for more because they definitely got, you know, did well, and then they took a dip. Mm-hmm. And then, like, with anything else, I don't know how it is now, but, like, you know, with any kind of power, some people might be trying to take advantage of it or not. Like, I don't really know, you know, the story behind it, but, like, I'm sure that he wanted it to be fair, you know what I mean? He didn't want to, like, you know, make them rich from whatever it is. But if you're working 15 hours a day, like, give them breaks, you know?
Yeah.
Give them some water, you know? Let them have time to eat food, you know? And that's what he wanted. He wanted equality for that. And I'm like, and for his time, he got it. But if he was around right now, he'd definitely still be working on it.
People are starting to lose hope, and I don't blame them. They know the growers have broken the strike with the illegal workers. And the sweetheart deal with the Teamsters. We can't ask them to keep going when they see people working in the fields. We have to take the next step.
You're too weak.
We have no laws to protect us here. With the boycott, there are no laws to stop us. This is the moment, Cesar. This is what we came here to do.
I haven't had a chance to tell you since the SAG Awards. Congratulations.
Thank you, man.
On the cast for American Hustle. I wonder, you know, this year's Oscars was kind of important for representation. People call it the Black and Brown Oscars with 12 Years and Gravity doing so well. Do you think that as an industry, the industry is starting to embrace this change that you spoke of earlier?
Yeah, that's I think that's exactly correct, man. I'm like, I gotta be honest, I'm like, I thought 12 Years a Slave was an amazing movie. I was doing a movie with Brad Pitt at the time. I didn't see it till I got back in the States, blown away. And then I also got to see my movie, American Hustle, and I was like, wow. It's an exciting time, man. Times are changing, and you just gotta be part of the bus, you know what I mean? You just gotta hop on the bus and, like, you know, just suck it all in.
All right, well, appreciate your time.
Yeah, you. Right on, man. Thank you.